Welcome back to World News. Today, we're diving deep into the complex history of Afghanistan and why it's known as the graveyard of empires. From its turbulent past to its current global significance, let's explore how this nation has shaped the world stage. One, historical context. To understand Afghanistan today, we have to go back to the 19th century. The rivalry between the British and Russian empires kicked off what we call the Great Game. Both powers wanted control over Afghanistan for its strategic position in South Asia. In 1839, the British sent 16,500 troops into Afghanistan, but they faced fierce resistance. Most of them were killed, a harbinger of the challenges foreign powers would face in this rugged land. Two. Rise of modern Afghanistan. Fast forward to the early 20th century, under King Zahir Shah, who took the throne in 1933, Afghanistan enjoyed a brief period of stability. He modernized the country and introduced a constitution in 1964. But this peace was short-lived. In 1973, Zahir Shah was overthrown by his cousin, Daud Khan, who tried to implement democracy but faced widespread opposition. By 1978, the Communist People's Democratic Party took control, with Soviet support. Three, Mujahideen and Soviet invasion. The rise of the PDPA sparked discontent, leading to the formation of the Mujahideen, a coalition of fighters defending their beliefs against the communist regime. This conflict escalated when the Soviet Union invaded in 1979. Backed by the U.S. and its allies, the Mujahideen fought back fiercely, leading to significant losses for the USSR and culminating in their withdrawal in 1989. 4. Post-Soviet chaos. After the Soviet withdrawal, Afghanistan spiraled into civil war. Amidst the chaos, the Taliban emerged, promising stability and implementing strict Sharia law after taking Kabul in 1996. During this time, Osama bin Laden established Al-Qaeda in Afghanistan, creating an alliance that would have global ramifications. 5. 9/11 and U.S. invasion. September 11, 2001 changed everything. After the attacks, the U.S. demanded the Taliban hand over bin Laden. Their refusal led to Operation Enduring Freedom, aiming to dismantle Al-Qaeda and oust the Taliban. The initial invasion was swift, but establishing a stable government proved much more challenging. 6. Rise of insurgency. As attention shifted to Iraq in 2003, the Taliban regrouped, gaining ground amid growing local discontent due to civilian casualties from military operations. The release of classified documents in 2010 exposed the extent of these casualties, leading to increased scrutiny of U.S. involvement. 7. Withdrawal and afterward. In 2020, the U.S. signed the Doha Agreement, paving the way for withdrawal, but leaving the Afghan government out of negotiations proved disastrous. By August 2021, the Taliban quickly reclaimed power as U.S. troops withdrew, resulting in heartbreaking scenes at Kabul airport as Afghans sought to flee. 8. Current situation and global implications. Since regaining power, the Taliban has faced severe challenges, including a humanitarian crisis fueled by international sanctions and a crumbling economy. Millions of Afghans are in dire need of assistance. Despite promises of moderation, reports of increasing restrictions on women's rights have drawn widespread condemnation globally. Conclusion. Montage of Afghan culture and resilience. Afghanistan's history is a tapestry of conflict and resilience. As the world watches, it's clear that the challenges facing this nation are not just local, they're global. If you found this deep dive into Afghanistan's complex history insightful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more global news. Thanks for watching World News.